One Epping Forest. While I have spent most of my life living on the outskirts of London, I am someone who constantly craves the serenity of the natural world. I love the city too much to ever move to the countryside permanently. Instead, I make sure I have regular nature fixes with long walks in Epping Forest. As soon as I get there, I feel incredibly tranquil. I'm not sure if it is all that oxygen from the trees or the beautiful scenery, but it is instantly calming. Considering it's so close to the city, the wildlife in Epping Forest is quite amazing. I've seen badgers and foxes and even the odd deer there. Point to my sisters. I have three wonderful sisters and we are all close in age and heavily involved in each other's lives. Along with our mum Joan, who is 91 and lives nearby, we all get together 2 or 3 times a week, and having that close female camaraderie really is an important part of my life. Of course, there is the odd disagreement from time to time, but we are all naturally optimistic and full of fun, which means none of us can ever be cross for long. I am incredibly blessed to have a wonderfully close relationship with my daughter Louise. 2.3 Acting. My first love was ballet, which I started at the age of 3, but at 14 I turned my attention to acting. Before going to drama school, I took my O-levels and did a secretarial course in case I needed something to fall back on if the acting didn't work out. But luckily, I went on to have a brilliant career, and at 18 I was performing opposite Dudley Moore in a West End production of Play It Again, Sam. After that, I didn't look back. Even after all these years, I still love performing, especially on the stage. There is something so magical about watching an audience's reaction change as a story unfolds. Point 4. I pencil. Me mother brought us girls up to take pride in our appearance, and I have never been the kind of woman who feels comfortable hopping to the shops without putting my face on first. So when I was a contestant on I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here in 2014, it was daunting having to give up all my creature comforts. We were only allowed to take one luxury item with us, and mine was an eye pencil. It was great as it doubled up as an eyeshadow and a lip liner too. When it was confiscated after I failed a bush tucker trial, I created my own rather unorthodox eye makeup by applying smudges of charcoal from my lamp to my brows with a leaf. 5. Charity work. I am someone who likes to roll up my sleeves and get involved, and I feel it is very important to try to give something back, which is why I have always worked with so many different charities. Doing something for others makes you feel good, and the organizations that I support all deal with issues close to my heart. They range from Wet Nose Animal Aid, who work to protect vulnerable animals, Haven House Children's Hospice in Essex, and Keep Britain Tidy. As I'm not the most organized person in the world, I tend to end up racing around, but I would rather that than sitting at home and doing nothing. Vicky runs Trading Faces, which provides after-dinner and motivational speakers. Visit tradingfaces.co.uk.